संतौ श्रील रूप सनातनो दाक्षिणात्येन भट्टेन पुनरेत द्विविच्यते तस्याद्यं ग्रंथनालेकं क्रांतव्युत्क्रांतखंडितं पर्यालोच्याथ पर्यायं कृत्वा लिखति जीवकः। मंगलाचरण, आप सब लोग भी, एवरीवन कैन सिंग, इट्स नॉट दैट ओनली फॉर टीचर एंड सक्सेसफुली ही शुड कंप्लीट, बट इफ यू सिंग यू विल आल्सो सक्सेसफुली कैन हियर। ओके, आई होप यू आल्सो वांट ऑस्पिशियसनेस फ्रॉम सिलजीव गोस्वामी। हरे कृष्णा। So welcome to today's Bhakti Sandarbha session. So we are all discussing about two slokas. Till now we have seen three. Savaipam Samparo Dharmo Vasudevi Bhagavati Bhakti Yoga Prayojitaha. Next third sloka is Dharma Sunishtitaha Pumsam. This section we took from first canto, second chapter, Sutta Goswami's teachings. So in that, so we took from 6 to 22 to establish what is the best process, what the process is given there to attain paratattvam, or otherwise to be sanmukha to paratattvam. So what process we should take, that we are investigating. And the first sloka is Savaipam Samparo Dharmo. In that sloka, dharma means what is done for the satisfaction of the Hari, and that dharma should lead to what? Bhakti. There we understood bhakti means Vasudeva Katha Ruchi. And also then bhakti, if anyone does, what will happen? That will bring the yasyasti bhaktir bhagavat yakinchana. So by this we should understand the rule is, if anyone does bhakti, that bhakti will bring all the auspicious qualities. Yes, all the good qualities are coming and staying where there is bhakti. In whom ever bhakti is there, so all good qualities will reside there. Next, after that, dharma swanishtitaha pumsam vishvaksena kathasyaha notpadayat yadiratim srema evahi kevalam. So what we are understanding here also, in the reverse way it is said, if dharma which is properly done, if it is not going to give the Vasudeva Katha Ruchi, then that dharma is useless. So that's why yesterday on the board also I explained, dharma which is done for the Haritoshanam, that will bring the Vasudeva Katha Ruchi. Otherwise, dharma may be done for what purpose? For the pravritti. That means srema eva hi kevalam. Eva and kevalam, these two words are stressing the importance of doing dharma for the sake of Hari, which leads to the katha ruchi. So that is stressed by saying eva kevalam. So eva is indicating pravritti lakshana dharma, pravritti lakshana karma dharma. That means dharma, if it is done for the artha, and that artha is utilized for the just enjoying the sense objects, then this will lead to the sense enjoyment, and once again doing dharma. So this kind of dharma is useless, because of course one cannot say that dharma can give the artha, and that artha can be utilized for the sense enjoyment. But what we are saying, anything, that means the highest thing by dharma, what we can achieve, that is a swarga, and that swarga, so karma jitaha, lokaha, kshiyate. So that means any loka which is achieved by the karma, that is going to finish. That means it is diminished, it has to come back from there. And also dharma, if you done for the nivritti, means to be detached. So then that dharma also will give the knowledge, and that knowledge which is just without the bhakti, because here you are not having any bhakti and simply doing dharma for the detachment. So in that case, that knowledge, whatever is coming from that nivritti paraka dharma, is also useless, because so naishkarmyam apechyuta bhavarjitam, this is also saying any jnana without the bhakti is useless, or any karma just done for the detachment, so that is also useless. And also shreya srutim bhakti mudasya, this sloka is also saying, so any bhakti, leaving the bhakti and trying for only jnana, that is also is useless. It cannot be, it is just a kleshala shishyate, just is hard labor, like just beating the empty husk, so you will not get any rice from there. So similarly, there is one more thing, even somehow or other, someone, so by this kind of nivritti paraka dharma, so if he get the jivan mukti stage, still he will fall down from there. Because without bhakti, if you leave the lotus feet of the Supreme Lord, and just by the jnana, if you reach to the jivan mukta stage, also you will fall down from there. So then after this, we discussed, that means from this context, we understood that. So bhakti is nirapeksha, bhakti is independent, bhakti is not dependent on anyone, but on the reverse, jnana and vairagya, so on, are dependent on bhakti. That means they are sapeksha. Bhakti is nirapeksha, jnana and karma are sapeksha. So this much we discussed. And next, so we are going to go to next anuscheda. Sixth anuscheda. Write the questions. Please write the questions. In sloka, in SB 1.2.6, dharma means dharma which is meant for satisfaction of Hari. Prove this. Okay. Next, second question. In SB 1.2.6, what do you mean by bhakti here? And give the proof. Only one time, I also forget. Huh? Only one time I can say, or two times. You can ask others, because I also forget. Huh? Proof. Okay. These are all just two mark questions. Next. Explain the significance of the terms Eva and Kevalam in SB 1.2.8. Okay, clear? And for the previous Anushitas, just I am giving what are the three kinds of the three categories of the jivas? What are the three categories of jivas? Give the definition of Siddha Vakya and one example. Next question. Siddha Vakya. Give the definition of Siddha Vakya and give an example. Explain the flow of steps for jivas dukkham. No, changing. This one is okay. Marks will decide later, no problem. Your answers are direct. Okay. And next, okay, this much. I will add questions later. Prepare for these questions. We'll be having exam. So now we'll do the sixth anucheda. Come to this, I will share the screen. Is there? Not so you'll get so. Is there? Tatra yad anya manyante dharmasya artha phalam tasya kamaha dharmasya phalam artha aradarvai dharmasya artha phalam tasya kamaha tasya cha indriya pritihi tat pritescha punar api dharmadi parampara iti tacha anyatheiveti aha dvabhyam. This is the Vishayavakya. Sorry, this is the Sutrasthaneyam Vakyam. It is Avatara Vakyam. Avatarika Vakyam, introductory statement. So in this sixth Anucheda, what we are seeing, the English translation is like this. English is not there. Acha. Okay, I will send just 1 second. I am sending to group a file. Only Moola is there, but yeah. Please check in your WhatsApp group. 60 didn't put in this. Okay, no problem. Sorry, actually, sixth English is not there. Sixteen. Okay, I will explain. I will send after later, sometime later. So just you hear from me. Actually, yeah. Sorry for inconvenience. Now you check. Huh? Second one. So you see now the sixth one this. Okay, here you see. सो तत्र यद् अन्ये मन्यन्ते धर्मस्य अर्थः फलं तस्य कामस्य तस्य च इन्द्रियप्रीतिः तत्प्रीतेश्च पुनः धर्मादिपरम्परा इति तच्च अन्यथैव इत्याह द्वाभ्याम् सो अदर्स् थिङ्क् दट् द रिसल्ट् आफ् धर्म ईस् मेटीरियल् आब्जेक्ट्स् एव्री वन् चेक् इन् युवर् वाट्सप् सेकेण्ड् फैल् ऐ सेण्ड् ओपेन् दट् अण्ड् सी सिक्स्त् अनुच्छेद अनुच्छेद नम्बर् सिक्स् इस् देर् Online students, please try to follow these files because in my laptop I am not able to download, so that's why I am not able to show because my WhatsApp is not connected somehow. Okay. Okay, you can open and see that. Okay. So the English translation is, everyone able to open? Any difficulty? Huh? No internet. Then what we can do? That's your problem. So now the result of these objects is fulfillment of desire, and the result of fulfillment of desire is pleasure of the senses. That pleasure again gives rise to the sequence of dharma and so on. That is also stated to be wrong by the next two verses. These two verses, dharmasya hyapavargasya narthortayopakalpate narthasya dharmaikantasya kamo labhaya hi smritaha kamasya nendriya pritir labo jiveta yavata jivasya tatva jignasa nartho yascheha karma bihi. Okay, so these two slokas, till now generally in the society what is the belief? Dharma is meant for the production of the, what is the result of dharma? That is artha, and that artha is meant for the kamaha. Kamaha means sense enjoyment, so that means gratifying the senses. So or otherwise, by the artha, one will get the objects which can be enjoyed by the senses. And then after that, from this, what will get? Indriya Pritihi, that means sense enjoyment. And then what will they do? Since they are getting the sense enjoyment, they will be getting the more encouragement to do dharma, and they will do more strictly dharma, and that will produce even more artha, and then they will purchase more and more or get more goods or objects for the senses, and then by enjoying those, they will gratify their senses. So like this, they will be rotating in this loop. They will be rotating like this. And this kind of thing, this kind of philosophy is rejected by the Sotu Goswami. In general society, they think like this, but it is rejected. I don't know to sum. Okay, this is the file. Next, dharmasya hyapavargasya. What is the meaning of this sloka? Material objects are not the goal of dharma, which results in bhakti. That is apavarga. Artha, which is obtained from such dharma alone, is not for fulfillment of material desires. Next, kamasya nindri priti. The meaning of this sloka is, the fulfillment of material desires, kama, is not in attaining pleasure of the senses, but to maintain life. The goal of life is inquiry into tattva, but not attaining swarga by performing karmas. Okay, this is the two sloka. These are the two next two slokas, 1.2. So 9 and 10, till 8 we have seen. 9 and 10 are this. What these two slokas are doing? These two slokas are the rejecting the general belief about the dharma in the society. In the generally pravritti marga, whoever is in the pravritti marga, they do dharma for the artha, and artha will give the objects for the senses, and by that enjoyment, so they will be encouraged and they will be doing again dharma. So this is rejected. That's why what he is saying, dharmasya hyapavargasya na artha. Arthaya upakalpate. What is the meaning of this? Dharmasya hyapavargasya arthaya artha na upakalpate. Means dharmasya, that means dharma's result. Dharma's result is not artha. Dharmasya, that means the result of dharma is not artha. And arthasya dharmaikantasya. Artha always follow the dharma. Dharma is always follow the, sorry, artha always follow the dharma. So that's why it is also known as dharmaikantasya. So that kind of artha is what is the profit by having the artha? That is not kama. Arthasya kamaya kamaha labhaya hi smritaha. That means this artha's goal is not the kamaha. Is not the kama. Kama means so desires, material desires. Artha is not meant for kamaha, means material desires. Dharma's result is not artha. Artha's is not meant for the material desires. And kamasya na indriya pritihi. Kama is not meant for the gratification of the senses. Kama means accepting the sense objects. You are eating, you are wearing, you are sitting, you are so many things you are doing. So that means you are giving, you are feeding the objects to the senses. So that is not meant for indriya pritihi. So labho jiveta yavata. That is kamasya nendriya pritir labho jiveta yavata. Then why you accept the objects for the senses? Only to? No. Labho jiveta yavata. Just for the maintaining the body. Just to maintain the body, you will accept the objects for the senses. That means you eat, you drink, or you sleep, whatever you do, that the purpose is just to maintain life. Next, jivasya. Then what is the need of living, maintaining the body and soul together? Jivasya tattva jignasa. Jiva is meant for the tattva jignasa. Just to inquire about the tattva. Nartho yascheh karma bihi. This life is not meant for the performing the yajñas and getting the swarga sukha. No. Life is not meant for performing yajñas and getting the heavenly pleasure. Okay. This is the general meaning of these two slokas. Now we are going to do some investigation we do. That means Jiva Goswami is explaining by his commentary. So here you see. Here, dharma means what? Here, what is the meaning of dharma? Dharma is not meant for the artha, is said here. So what dharma here? What is this dharma? Then dharma is meant for what? Dharma is meant for what? That is we have to see. Here in this sloka, dharma means is said as what? Dharmasya apavargasya. So Ramchandra Prabhu, what is the problem? Second file you didn't get? Naimila, I sent na second file also. Nobody got, I'm sending once again. Acha, internet is not there here. Net problem. Why internet? Okay, that's why you all closed the doors, na? That's why nets are not working. That is the reason actually. Because of AC, this internet is not working. That's why any one pleasure you can take, one facility. Either internet or the AC. What do you want? AC. See, everyone want AC. So then what we should do? Okay. Okay. One second. Jai Gopinath Prabhu, what are you saying?
I think the second file you sent was Anucheda 7. It is from Anucheda 7 onwards.
No. This is complete. Becoming mesh. Okay, there's a problem actually. There is internet problem is here. Okay, don't worry about this. I can explain everything easily. You can see in my screen. You can see easily see in my screen. I'm showing on my screen. Okay. So now, dharmasya hyapavargasya narthortha yopakalpate. This one is there. Then what is the dharmasya? Dharma means what here? Apavargyasya is said. It is the apavargaha. Apavargaha means what? So dharmas here, another name is given as apavargaha. So now we'll try to understand the apavargasya. So then it is said, the meaning of apavarga in the 5th canto, 19th chapter, 20th. Yatha varna vidanam apavargascha bhavati yoso bhagavati sarvatmanyatme nirukte nilanene paramatmani vasudeve ananya nimitta bhakti yoga lakshano nana gati nimitta vidya grandhi randana dvarena yadahi mahapurusha purusha prasangaha iti panchamaskanda gadyanusarena apavargo bhakti hi tathacha skande reva khande. This is the thing. This you can see in the your Sanskrit also. In the Sanskrit file it is there. In the BS2, that's the Sanskrit file, is there. So, yeah, now everyone received, I think. So it is sent somehow. Okay. This is the English translation of this is liberation is then achieved apavargaschapi bhavati. So yoso bhagavati sarva bhutanyat anatme. This English translation is that liberation whose essential nature is unmotivated bhakti yoga to the Lord, full of qualities, who attracts the minds of all beings, who is not the object of merging, who is not described by material words. So, yeah, material words, who remains beyond destruction of the universe, who is the most excellent Atma, who is the son of Vasudeva, takes place by destruction of naught of ignorance, which cause various material goals when there is association with the devotees of the Lord. In this, so you don't need to, focus on the total meaning. Main thing is, what you have to understand here, ityadi panchama skandha gadyanusarena apavargaha bhakti. Apavargaha is the bhakti. So in this gadhya, you try to see. In the gadhya, what is said? Apavargaschapi bhavati. Apavarga also happens. To whom? Yaha asau bhagavati. Bhagavati. And these are all visheshanas for this. So, yadahi mahapurusha prasangaha. So, whenever anyone do get the association of the devotees, for him what will happen? Apavarga will happen. I will write on this only. Everyone able to see my screen? So what we are doing, so see here. Where is this? Okay. 1.2.9. That is our discussion today. Okay. In this 1.2.9, we are seeing the dharmasya. Dharmasya apavargasya. We are seeing this. Okay, what is this dharmaha? We are trying to understand. This is what? Apavargasya. Apavargasya is given. It means whatever is dharma, that is apavargaha. Dharma is the apavargaha. From this, we are understanding. Dharma means apavargaha. This is also Shashti Ekavachan 6.1 and this is also 6.1. They are in the Samana Vibhakti. That means for the dharma, apavarga is the visheshana. Okay, whatever is dharma, that is apavargaha. Dharma is equal to what? Apavargaha. Shashti Ekavachan. Shashti Vibhakti Prathama singular Ekavachanam. 6.1 means Shashti Ekavachan. Dharmasya is the Shashti Ekavachan. 6.1, why you are saying? So this dharma is also in 6.1. Apavarga, it is also 6.1. They are both are in the same Vibhakti. So that means then for dharma, apavarga is the visheshana. Yeah. So that means dharma is apavargaha. Agaya. So now dharma is the apavargaha. Then what is meaning of apavargaha? That you should understand. That is our target. Okay. So now to know this, we are going to the 5th canto, 19th chapter, verse 19 and 20. So in this sloka, what is said? So some yaha mane, so yatha apavargaha bhavati varna vidhanam idanam apavargascha bhavati yaha asau bhagavati. The one who do the bhakti yoga, one who yo asau bhagavati paramatmane vasudeve bhakti yoga lakshana nana gati nimittaka vidya grandini dwara yadahi manusha purusha sangha iti. So there it is said, if someone associate with the devotees, then in him what will happen? So bhakti will happen, and that bhakti is nothing but what? Apavargaha. There it is mentioned bhakti as apavargaha. So ultimately, if you examine 5.19.19 to 20, these two gadhyas, you will be understanding apavargaha is equal to apavargaha is equal to what? Bhakti. That you are going to get. Okay, you got this. And also, there is one more thing. What is that? That is from the Skanda Purana Revakanda. Skanda Purana Revakanda. So according to this Skanda Reva, what is said? You see? Nishchala Tvayi Bhaktir Ya Saiva Muktihi Janardhana Mukta Hevihi Bhakta Hate Tava Vishnu Yato Hare. So what is the meaning of this? The meaning of this sloka is, where is this? Achha. I should close. So here, I think we should share the pura complete this desktop. This one, na? Then if you share everything, whatever is there, you can see there. Yeah. So now from this Skanda Purana Revakanda statement, what we are understanding, the meaning is like this, you see. O Janardana, O Lord, unswearing bhakti to you is liberation, mukti or apavargaha. Since those who are liberated are devotees of Vishnu. So from this statement we are understanding what? Unswearing bhakti to you is liberation. That means apavargaha is what? Bhakti. Why you are taking apavarga is equal to bhakti? Generally apavarga means moksha. But here apavarga is we are taking bhakti because so devotees only really liberated. So from this real mukti will come to whom? To the devotees only. Those who are liberated are devotees of Vishnu. Devotees of the Vishnu only really they get the mukti. So that's why bhakti is known as mukti or the apavargaha. According to the Revakanda also, we are understanding apavargaha is equal to what? Apavargaha is equal to what? Is the apavarga is equal to bhakti or otherwise? Yeah. Apavargaha is equal to bhakti. According to this also. Did you get this how? According to Revakanda, apavarga is equal to bhakti. Anyone have doubt? Questions? Apavarga is equal to bhakti. Apavarga is equal to bhakti. What one time? So one more time, what you want?
I want this explanation again. What is?
Total class.
No. No, only apavarga.
Apavarga is equal to, we want to understand, dharma is equal to apavargaha. So apavargaha is coming from apavargaha. Like Kaunteya is coming from Kunti. Kunti putra is equal to Kaunteya. Like that apavargaha is coming from apavargaha. So if you want to know apavargaha, you should know what is apavargaha. Because in this sloka, what is there? Dharmasya hyapavargasya is there. Apavargaha is there in the sloka. So what is the apavarga? You should understand. To understand apavargaha, what you should know? You should know apavargaha. Apavargaha means what? Apavargaha means what? Bhakti. Okay? So apavargaha is equal to bhakti. According to the 5.19.20 to 19.20. And also according to the Skanda Revakanda. Okay? Next. Right. So now, then after that, tataha uktaritya bhakti sampadakasya ityardaha. Apavargaha is equal to bhakti, you understood. Now apavargaha is what? Then what is apavargaha? Apavargaha is bhakti and then apavarga means bhakti sampadakaha. What is that? Bhakti sampadakaha. So apavarga is the bhakti sampadakaha. Okay, this is, if you can see the mula, there it is there. Tataha uktaritya bhakti sampadakasya ityardaha. That means apavargasya means bhakti sampadakasya. Take. Okay, got it? What Purushottam Prasad Prabhu? Purushottam Prabhu? Who is this?
Prabhuji Hare Krishna Dandatna.
Yes, Prabhuji Hare Krishna.
Prabhu, this Apavargaha, we have a famous verse in Srimad Bhagavatam, 6th canto, 17th chapter.
Yes, Prabhu.
I think 28th verse. 6, 17, 28. Narayana parasarve na kutaschana vibhyati. Swarga apavargaha narakeshu apitulyata darshinaha. So there Prabhupada saying apavargaha means liberation.
Yes.
So the context is changing according to the verses. Apavargaha, there it is liberation, here it is bhakti.
Yes. Yes, Prabhu. Apavargaha is moksha, is also we can say.
Okay, okay.
And now apavargaha we want to say as bhakti. Is there any proof for this? Yes, it is there. 5th canto, 19th chapter, 19 to 20. Apavargaha means you can take bhakti also.
Mm-hmm.
Also in the Skanda Purana Revakonda also it is said, apavargaha means bhakti. That is our main target actually. So now, apavargaha is equal to bhakti. Then apavargaha, what is the apavargaha? Tell me. What is the apavargaha?
Must be the prema to the Lord.
Apavargaha is prema. How, Prabhu? So that which produces bhakti. What I said, see in this board, what I wrote, apavargaha means bhakti sampadakaha. Means what? Which produces bhakti.
Correct, Prabhu. Without prema, how bhakti can be produced?
Achha. After prema, bhakti will come. Which produces bhakti. What do you want to say, Prabhu?
Now, apavargaha, which produces bhakti.
Yes.
So, a devotion, bhakti, devotional service. If we don't love somebody, how this apavarga will be spontaneous?
No, if you do bhakti, then you will get prema. So, prema we are not getting first. Prema will come later. First, we should get the sraddha. Then after that, you should do the bhajana. Then you will get the last final prema. Prema, if you have first itself, then no need to do any bhakti. Okay.
Okay, thank you.
Okay. So, nothing, till now we didn't discuss nothing more. So, we'll first discuss some subject. Then we'll take the doubts, questions. Okay, you understood now. In this sloka, dharmasya hyapavargasya means there you should what? Dharma is equal to apavarga. Apavarga means which produces bhakti. Means here also dharma means which produces bhakti. According to Savai Pumsa also there dharma is equal to which produces bhakti. Okay? And also according to the dharma Sonashita Pumsa, there also dharma means which produces bhakti. Also in that Atabumbir Dhuvisheshtra Varanashram Vibhagraha Swanishtitasya Dharmasya Samsiddhya Haritoshanam. There is also dharma means which is done for the satisfaction of Hari. Okay, is the same. That means if you whole in this whole context dharma means what you should take? Which produces bhakti. Bhakti means Vasudeva Katha Ruchi. That means dharmasya hyapavargasya narthordhayopa kalpate. That means the dharma which is going to produce bhakti, so its result is not artha. Its result is what? What is the result of that dharma? Everyone is seeing with blank face. That is bhakti. Please try to understand. So next, we'll go to the... So dharmasya hyapavargasya narthordhayopa kalpate. So that means the dharma which is meant for the bhakti, so that's result is not artha. Here, Srila Jogosam is saying, tikacha. You see, tikacha in the mula. How to remove this one, this bar? This bar I don't want anywhere. How to send this somewhere? This bar is simply disturbing me. No, Siraj, ठीक है छोड़ दो. बार बार ये पूरा वाई दिस इज हियर. पूरा एकदम इतना फाइल्स कंप्लीटली बोगस. समवेयर मूला समवेयर ट्रांसलेशन कंप्लीटली सो मेनी फाइल्स ऑलवेज ओपनिंग. हटाओ. ओके it's okay, it's okay. Later. So now Tika says, Tika cha arthaya falatvaya arthaha na upakalpate yogyaha na bhavati tatha arthasya api evam bhuta dharma avyabhicharinaha kamo labhaya falatvaya nahi smritaha tattva vidbihi. So here, now you come to the next portion of this sloka. धर्मस्य ह्यापवर्गस्य. सो अर्थ दट मीन्स इज नॉट द पॉसिबल रिजल्ट ऑफ द धर्म. धर्म इज मेंट फॉर व्हाट? इज मेंट फॉर द भक्ति. एंड फॉर दट काइंड ऑफ धर्म अर्थ इज नॉट द इज द प्रॉपर रिजल्ट. इट कैनॉट बी फिटिंग. इट कैनॉट बी अप्रोप्रिएट फॉर दट धर्म. अर्थ कैनॉट बी रिजल्ट. Then what can be the result for that kind of dharma? Bhakti is the result. That bhakti should be result. That's why what Sutta Goswami is saying, dharmasya yapavargasya narthortayopakalpate. That means dharma means here which brings the bhakti. And for that dharma, artha is not the result. But what is the result? Bhakti is the result. And next, arthasya tatha artha. But if you do dharma which is going to give bhakti, but there is, wherever there is dharma there is some artha will come automatically. Definitely artha will come, but of course the main result is bhakti, but artha will come na. So then what is the use of that artha? What is the use of that artha? What we should do that artha with that artha? That arthasya, the artha is not meant for the accumulating the objects for the senses. That artha is not meant for the accumulating the objects for the senses. But what you should use that artha to gather the objects for the senses, so that those objects you can just maintain your life, not for the sense gratification. Not for the sense gratification. That's why kamasya nendriya pritir. So if you make a diagram of this, it will be like this. You see, now I am making a small diagram for all of you so that you can easily understand things. So our Suta Goswami is saying in 1.2.9, another samasya, 9 and 10. So here what he is saying, dharma, same thing I am repeating for everyone. Dharma is meant for bringing bhakti. That means its result is bhakti. But if you do dharma, you will be getting the sum artha. Because why artha will come? Because artha is the dharmaikantaha. Why artha will come from this dharma also? Because dharma is, artha is always the follower of dharma. Dharmaikantasya. Dharmaikantaha. Artha. So that means you will get some artha also. Then what is the purpose of this artha? What should not be the purpose of this artha? This artha is not for the accumulating the objects for the senses. So that means this artha, this is not for accumulating objects for the senses. It's not for this. But for what? This is not for the accumulated objects for the senses, and from those objects, and those objects are not meant for sense gratification. That means you got the objects for the senses and take those senses and gratify your senses. That is not the purpose. And those objects not meant for sense gratification. Yo. Not meant for sense gratification. But for what? Now, whatever this artha is there, this artha, you should use this artha to get the objects necessary to maintain body and soul together. Okay, you should use this artha just to get objects for the maintaining the body, not for the sense gratification. Okay, then after that means you get those objects and consume it, no problem. So that your body and soul maintain. Then what is the purpose of? So next you see the in the Sanskrit. So Tika, what he is saying? Then you are maintaining the body. Then what is the use of that body? Maintaining the body, for the. तावान एव कामस्य लाभः तादृश जीवन पर्याप्तय एव कामः सेव्यः. That means just to maintain body, you should accept the sense objects. जीवस्य जीवनस्य च पुनर धर्मानुष्ठान द्वारा. Okay. So that you can maintain your body together, and this जीवस्य च पुनर धर्मानुष्ठान द्वारा कर्मभिः यः इह प्रसिद्धिः स्वर्गादिः स्वार्थो न भवति किन्तु Tattva Jignasa. To maintain this body together, what is it? Tattva Jignasa. This is for what? Tattva Jignasa. This is meant for Tattva Jignasa. Okay. And not this maintaining the body is not meant for what? No. Maintaining doing yajna. Nartho yascheha karma bihi means doing karma means yajna. So yajna, doing yajna to get swarga. Okay. This is not meant, that's why cross is said here. Okay. You understood now? So now Tattva Jignasa you want to do. You have to do that Tattva Jignasa by this. So then what is the Tattva? What is Tattva? What is the Tattva? That's why coming next sloka. Vadanti Tattva Vidas Tattvam Yajnanam Advayam ब्रह्मेति परमात्मेति भगवान् इति शब्द्यते. Now before going to the next sloka, any question? Anyone is not able to understand? Okay. Akshay Hari Prabhu.
This is a simple question, Bo. Like we know that the real liberation is bhakti, and yes, all other liberation are not real liberation actually.
Yes.
But general understanding of liberation is apavarga is liberation, like a mukti, any kind of mukti. And here we are saying just to have our to prove that apavarga is bhakti, we took some shloka instead of generalist understanding. We took specific what is needed for us. We know it is right, but is it right? Looks like a wrong practice. Instead of taking general definition, we are taking specific definition just to fit our need.
Akshay Hari Prabhu's question is, now in this sloka, dharmasya hyapavargasya. So here you are taking the specific meaning of the apavarga. General meaning of apavarga is what? What is the general meaning? Mukti. So you are not taking the mukti, but you are taking here bhakti. So why you are doing like this? Apavarga, you are taking bhakti, and apavarga means which brings the bhakti. So like this we are taking. Why you are taking like this? So general thing is bhakti. Apavarga means moksha, you should take mukti. So the answer is, see my dear, so in the 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, in many places dharma is coming. It's the one context actually. In the first Savaipumsam Paro Dharma, there dharma means what we took, so which brings the bhakti. And also after this coming, next slokas, that is Atapumbir Dvishesh Varanashram Vibhagashaha. So this is the coming sloka actually, even it is further sloka. So this sloka, so is a 13th sloka, 1 to 13. Here also dharma is there. Dharma means, what is that purpose of that dharma? Haritoshanam. That means that is also meant for the Hari's satisfaction. That means this sloka, the dharma syapavargasa is a 9. But previous to this is 6th. There also dharma means bhakti, which brings the bhakti. Here in the 13th sloka, there also you are taking dharma means, which is meant for the satisfaction of Hari. And not only that, so before to this, in this context, one more place dharma is coming. What is that? Dharma sonishtita pumsam. There also dharma, well-performed dharma, what it should do? It should bring the Vasudeva Katharuchi. So that means it is also should bring, that dharma also should bring bhakti. So that means, in this whole context, we are seeing everywhere dharma is equal to which bringing the bhakti. Now, here dharmasya apavargasya, how can you take dharma means which brings the liberation? How can you take? It is not possible. You cannot take like that. If you take, then it's completely rasabhas. Yes or no? Gokulanand Prabhu. You are going out of context. You say out of context. So that's a contextually we should take. Everywhere is already dharma is which brings bhakti. So that's why here also you should take. So that is also supported actually. Yes, apavarga is bhakti. It is also there in the other places. Okay, everyone. Okay. Yes. Who is that? Okay.
This na. Sambh Bhattacharya once reading there's 10th canto, there's verse is there na. Mukti pade sadai bhag. So Sambh Bhattacharya, he was
with that
Sarvabhaum Bhattacharya na.
Sarvabhaum Bhattacharya.
Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So he doesn't like mukti. He was saying here should be bhakti pade, not mukti pade sadai bhag.
Yes.
The Lord Chaitanya said, you can Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, you can't change Bhagavatam. Bhagavatam is as it is. Here mukti is meant for bhakti. Bhakti only. That is.
Yes.
So not like that mukti means only liberation. Just yes. There is a samasrita paddo pallo plo mahatpudam punya se murari. That verse mukti pade sadai bhag is there.
Where the mukti person, is bhakti.
Yeah. The mukti. Yeah.
Okay, next. Sri Chand Prabhu.
Prabhu, you told that by dharma we get artha. So generally, we, that is by what dharma? Dharma means what activities we get artha, Prabhu?
So what
like examples? Now we do job and get artha. So dharma is meant for.
Dharma means the prescribed duties. That's a Veda vihita karma. So whatever Vedas are prescribing for us, which is not sinful activity. It should not
but be. We defined dharma as that which produces samsiddhir haritoshanam and bhakti. Dharma is equal to bhakti, we told.
No. Dharma is not equal to bhakti. Dharma is the one which brings the bhakti. Dharma means, so here what? Which is prescribed for us. That's a Sridhar Swami commentary you will be seeing. So then he is saying the Agnihotra karma ityadi. That means, your varna, as a varna, so you'll be having your prescribed duty. So which is not a sinful activity. So it should not be a sinful activity, and which is prescribed for you based upon your dharma, your varna to you by the Shastra. That is the dharma here. Okay, Prabhu?
Yes, Prabhu.
Yeah. And yeah, next we'll go to the, what is tattva? Now we want to do what? So we follow dharma, which brings the bhakti, and that bhakti, yeah. So, and also it will produce some artha, and that artha is utilized for the bare necessities of the life. So by enjoying that, we can maintain body and life together, and so that we can do tattva jignasa. So what is tattva? Vadanti tattva vidastastvam yasgnanam advayam Brahmeti Paramatmeti Bhagavaniti Shabdate. So the Goswami is immediately explaining. Then he is saying that tattva is advayam gnanam. What is that? That is advayam gnanam. Sound problem? Prabhu? Jada are. Hare Krishna. Yes, Ashray Gauram Prabhu.
Prabhuji, one small question.
Yes,
in this, before this sloka, Vadanti Tattva, there is one sentence, if you can explain. Yeah. This sentence, Tadevam Tattva Jnanam, Yasya Bhaktir Avantara Phalam Uktam, Seva Parama Phalam Iti Bhava. If you can explain this sentence.
Yes, Prabhu. So, Tadevam Tattvagnanam Yasyaha Bhaktehe Avantara Phalam Muktam Saeva Parama Phalam Iti Bhava. So, what is this statement? Okay, yeah, anyway, it is missed. Thanks, Prabhu, for remembering us. So, here, Tadevam Tattvagnanam Yasyaha Bhaktehe Avantara phalam uktam. So saiva param phalam iti bhavaha. So that means what we are seeing, dharma should be done for the bhakti purpose. That means bhakti should be the main result. And by doing this dharma, it is producing the artha, and that is used to maintain the body and soul together. And that life is meant for the tattva jignasa. That means knowing the tattva. So inquiring about the tattva. That means tattva jignasa. This means knowing the tattva. And that knowing the tattva is nothing but the jnanam. That is what? That is avantara phalam. That is secondary reason. Hare Krishna. Sound is not clear? Online students, sound is clear or not?
Sound is like you are in mouth, something is there, like that sound is coming.
Huh?
Like.
Oh, acha. Fan band kari bro.
Maybe this microphone is very close to your mouth. You can remove little away.
This one? Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. This one? How is it?
Yeah, it's better.
Battery
down maybe.
Hare Krishna. Now it is okay? It is okay?
Better than before.
Okay, better than before. Okay. Just what question is asking, I'm trying to explain. So dharma's main result is what? Bhakti. And secondary result of this process is what? Tattvagnanam. Tattvagnanam is avantara phalam. Okay? Secondary result.
Okay. Avantara phalam is secondary result. Okay.
Yeah.
Side benefit. Huh? Side product.
Yes, side product. So, everyone understood that total thing clearly. So, this is dharma which is actually meant for bhakti. But we get some artha also. And that artha is meant for the maintaining the body. And that is maintain bodies, and then that maintain body is meant for what? Tattva jignasa. That means knowing the tattva. Tattva jnanam is what? It is the secondary result. Okay, then what is that tattva? Vadanti tattva. So advayam. So here tattva is said as advayam. Advayam means akhandam. Advayam. No two. It's not two, but it is one. So that means it is one. Tattvam is one. Akhandatvam. So by this what? Everything comes under into that only. This whole phenomenal and nominal, everything, all the creations, everything comes under to that tattvam only. Advayam. Because everything, whatever you are seeing, whatever you are experiencing, everything comes under that only. Because only one is there. If you say many are there, then okay, then you can take this as another thing, material world as another thing, and that supreme truth as one. But now tattvam is one, actually is the one only. Means then what about this material world? Tattvam is, you take that's Brahman or Paratattvam, and what about this material world? This is also included to that only. Because it is said as akhandam, it is one only. That means this is also included into that. That means what? This is energy of that. It is proving that tattvam is also having the energy. Understanding? Tattvam is having the shakti. Shakti means energy. How can you say? Since tattvam is said as advayam, is one. Since tattvam is said as one, then this material world is also experienced by us, and which is also real. It's not that this is simply fake. It's a real. We are experiencing. So jivatma is experiencing all this phenomenal world. It cannot be a simply illusion. We are experiencing. Then what is the relation between this and that? It is separate from that? No, because one only. Everything is one. So that's why it is also included into that. In what way? It is a Shakti, and that is Shaktiman. And in this way, you can understand that Tattvam is said, since here Advayam, it is automatically proved Shakti is also there with that Tattvam. Okay. Okay, now questions, 8 o'clock. Purushottam Prabhu. So are...
Abhijit, Andrat Pranam. First of all, please forgive me because the subject is so deep. I'm getting the basics has to be get corrected. So in my understanding, when you explain dharma which produces bhakti, that is ultimate.
Yeah.
And there is a byproduct which is also produces artha.
Yes.
That artha should not be the object of sense gratification, but to maintain artha, the body and soul together.
No, no, that artha you should not use to get the objects for the senses to enjoy, but you should get the objects to maintain the life.
Maintain the life, correct. So the dharma, that whatever dharma as per one's ashrama and varna one is performing,
yes,
it is ultimately to satisfy the Supreme Lord. That Krishna also says, yat karoshi yad ashnasi. That is clear. But finally, Krishna says, sarva dharma and parityajya. So if the same dharma is able to produce bhakti, then Krishna is rejecting, you give up dharma, then how shall we get the bhakti? This is, I'm getting confused, Prabhu. See, my understanding, when you give up all this dharma, which really produces bhakti, so that we will serve the Supreme Lord. Sarva dharman parityajya. Or do we understand there is a material dharma, there is spiritual dharma? How? I am getting confused, Prabhuji. Please help me.
Your confusion will be finished in the coming 4-5 slokas, after 5 slokas. Please maintain your confusion for another 2 more classes, then automatically it will go.
Thank you, Prabhu. Thank you.
Yeah, it will be coming, Prabhu.
Okay, right. Nice. Yeah.
Okay, any other questions? Thank you very much. Somehow today we have some disturbances. Okay, thank you very much. Srila Prabhupada ki.